for babies with gastroschisis. The average gestational age at the time of birth is between 35 and 37 weeks gestation, where term, of course, is 40 weeks. So as a rule, these babies come early. For gastroschisis, there is no advantage to a cesarean section delivery over a vaginal delivery in most cases.
There's some physiologic benefits to being delivered vaginally. It helps to squeeze some of the fluid out of the lungs. It triggers reabsorption of fluid within the lungs. It's less risk to the mother. The recovery time is certainly much more rapid after vaginal delivery and allows the mom to be down at the bedside within hours.
Of course, if there's a maternal indication for a cesarean section, or if a stressed gastroschisis fetus is having difficulty before birth, then a cesarean section might be mandatory.
It's critically important to watch these babies carefully during the labor process because they are kind of at the fringe and some of them may not tolerate labor, and failure to recognize that they're not tolerating that labor can result in a much, much more compromised child.
When a baby with gastroschisis is born and is then moved from the delivery room immediately to the resuscitation room, we need to assess the baby's breathing status, place an IV or two, place a nasogastric tube to decompress the intestine.
It's really important to keep the bowel decompressed so that you don't have reflux of gastric contents.
There's a risk that they could then aspirate or breathe that into their lungs, so that's a really critical step.
The thing we worry about is the constrictive effect of the abdominal wall defect can cause damage to the blood supply or blood drainage from the bowel. That can lead to loss of bowel, which can be difficult to repair.
So we have to have very careful positioning of the infant, usually on their right side, to take the pressure off that area, and very close surveillance of the bowel and whatever else is out to make sure that it looks well perfused and healthy.
By the time I got in there, the baby was already, I guess, what you would call prep. They basically put plastic over his body, so this way, I guess because of infection and to keep everything moist.
The baby started on antibiotics. In our protocol, the current time, for the most part, for uncomplicated gastroschisis, is to immediately place a spring-loaded silo. The concept is like a silo on a farm that contains grain. There's a long sheet, it's clear silastic, so you can see the intestine, and the intestine is placed sterilely into this sheet, and then the spring-loaded base then is manipulated to go inside the abdomen, and since the spring is larger, the circular spring is larger than the defect, it stays in place.
And it's suspended from the top of the baby's bed. With gravity, the bowel can then move from the silo into the abdomen.
After a day or two, we begin the process of daily reductions, where they gently squeeze on the silo and tie a piece of umbilical tape to hold the bowel down, so that you're creating a little bit of pressure on the intestines that are going into the abdomen.
And the baby's abdominal wall and abdominal capacity will increase dramatically from day to day, such that in the usual circumstance, within a week or sometimes substantially less than that, we can reduce the intestine into the abdomen, bring the baby to the operating room, remove the spring-loaded silo, close the fascia, the shrink layer, and then close the skin around the belly button, around the umbilical cord, such that a fairly normal appearing umbilicus is maintained.